Thank you, sir. Actually, 475th meeting for the MCA, the message of the MP like this. So, the DMOD on that day didn't mention that. I actually, I did the DMOD on that day.
So, it was right.
But it's okay. We are always open for tweet. Delhi is always open for tweet.
Minutes of the meeting.
Minutes of the meeting, yeah.
Record.
And yeah, it was a wonderful speech from DTM BN Subramanian sir. And the moment I saw motivational strategy, I got fried. Because I always have this fear. Someone says motivation, I'm like, oh. Like I have seen most of the people. So if you listen to a motivational speaker, you should get motivated and do your job. You shouldn't get motivated to become another motivation speaker. So like he's speaking, I can speak.
So I said one day I asked him, motivation na enna pa adhan sir nu theriyum ana na paniyete
irukku so that's all right. And even this books, how many of you read this book, Who Will Thrive When You Die? I read that and I started crying. so they mentioned all the things which no human can follow. He said all the things, you have to have this habit, you have to have this habit and kind of that. And
like a person in the
night. Yeah, five in the midnight, kind of thing. So that I don't like it. And books on self-help, it's the greatest irony that I have ever seen. Books on self-help.
Project of it.
Yeah. So they said this off. So don't do that.
Yeah.
And also, how many of you are working in IT? IT sector. Everyone is IT, right?
Too many fingers.
Yeah. Have you seen that in your work you will be having all these quotes, right? So in my office there is a quote like do or die. Like it's always impossible until you do it. Yeah. These are the quotes actually told by Gandhiji and Nelson Mandela. To bring people out of slavery. And see where it is hanging in. So I got frustrated. Like it's quotes in everywhere. I got frustrated, I went to Bottom and like think big. What are you going to think big in
your heart?
We have a special prize, a surprise prize at the end of this meeting. We'll be giving to the best dressed man.
Best male, if any.
I get that, don't worry.
No, ethnic wear.
Did you mention that?
Suitable.
Yes.
Suitable. The Indian meaning ethnic wear. Best dress out of you.
Now, see, he is in beach wear.
I saw some debates going on.
I'm rooting for you. You are the only best dress.
What happened, Satish?
Bias.
Shirt is not strictly ethnic.
Projector ready.
Okay. Ready. Yeah, thank you. And the next speaker is going to be DTM Sundaraman sir. And just give a little intro about him. He is the past president of Medley. He is the current Pathways ambassador. And he said, for him, festival is attending Toastmasters meeting. He always tells lies. But to read out his objective, I would like to call Toastmaster Mohan Subramanian, his evaluator.
DTM Sundaraman is giving his speech from the presentation mastery track in Pathways. The purpose of this speech is for the member to present a speech on any topic, receive feedback, and apply the feedback to his second speech. The purpose of this speech for the member is for the member to demonstrate that he or she has applied the feedback received from his first speech. Now, this is the second speech. He has already given this speech and he has shared the feedback with me. So, this is the second speech on the same topic. So, for me to evaluate mainly whether he has applied the feedback given by the first speech evaluator. How the best?
Thank you, Toastmaster Mohan. I'd like to call BTM Sundar Ramachandran. Mindfulness and she, BTM Sundar Ramachandran.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmasters and guests. Few months back, actually, some of my cousins, foreign written cousins, and we were all chatting and we were talking about a subject called the development of our place in Chennai. So one of us told that Cholinganallur has developed fast and it has developed like anything. And someone said Ambattur has developed like anything. You have to come and see. And at that time, we were all debating on what parameters we are calling this as development. So is the development, is it based on the kind of bridges, the kind of roads, artery roads, or the metro rail, or the kind of skyscrapers? So are they determining the quality of the development? We were debating, and finally we are not arrived at a conclusion. But I was pondering about this topic, and finally I thought that the development is not possible without tree. So I thought the development is possible only with tree. Who is this tree?
Safety health.
This is not changing that. This is an acronym.
Safety
refers to safety, health, and environment. Right. So this is a very close topic because I work in oil and gas industry where tree is always given importance. So if you analyze the development aspect of our today's any metro city, so if you see, so where do we have safety? So safety, if you see, every day we come across several incidents, safety incidents. Maybe a person getting hurt in the rail track, or a road accident, or any kind of accident. And in terms of health, always we also talk about dengue, malaria, so many epidemic and endemic fevers that keep happening. And finally, when we talk about the environment, always we litter, garbage, dump in the city, and many a times it is not clean in a proper frequency. Most of the time, at any point of time, if you inspect any of the roads and the lanes, you will be able to see lumps and lumps of garbages. But what is the root cause for all these incidents? Any incident related to safety, health, and environment? Then I finally came to a conclusion that it is because of lack of mindfulness. Mindfulness is an attitude where you think about a thing and do the same thing. While you are doing something, you think about that specific objective. Your mind is wandering somewhere, and if your mind is not in a particular activity, then finally you will not be meeting the objective, and that is where you will end up in problem. For example, when we talk about safety, I think when we are driving, we have to reach the destination and we have to reach in a safe manner. But what do we see today? Many a times people check their messages, they see WhatsApp, they see Facebook, and they will also upload, take a picture and then try to upload all this while driving or while waiting for the signal. And the second one is called jaywalking. I think most of you would have not heard about this term, but you would have seen this particular scenario. Especially in places like Tidal or Cholinganallur signal, the young IT professional getting down from the bus, keeping their headphone, earphone, and then simply walk across the road without minding the signal, and finally result in the accident. The third thing, I'm just showing a picture of a flight where the masks are fallen and people are wearing it. This incident happened just a few months back in Jet Airways. Anyone make a guess? What is that incident all about? Yes, this has happened in Jet Airways, and all the passengers were subject to, it was a flight from Nasik to Bombay, all the passengers were subject to heavy pressure, and more than a dozen people, they suffered with bleeding in their nose and ear. And finally, the doctors have told that it may take 6 months for them to get their normalcy in their hearing thing. And finally, the root cause is the crew member has forgotten to switch one of the valve called the bleed valve. And because of that, the air pressure was different. The cabin pressure was different, and that's why all the passengers were put into trouble. Of course, there was checklist, but I guess the crew members, they are not mindful while going through the checklist. When we talk about health, so this is the normal scenario in most of our lives. While eating our food, we don't eat what we have in the plate. And we watch TV or watch our mobile devices or read a book. And finally, whatever you eat, that is not properly assimilated. and finally resulting into so many health disorders and so many health problems. Then environment. So in my office, I have seen the cafeteria, there is a guy who is selling tender coconut, and he has got a bag where he put all the garbages and properly dump it, and then every day he disposes it. In the same cafeteria, I am seeing an ATM machine where people dump all the receipts. Doesn't mean that they are not educated. 100% of our employees, they are all educated and they have the awareness. But thing is, while taking the money from the ATM machine, they don't apply their mind. So they are only thinking about their expenses or the birthday party or the other kind of celebrations. But they don't apply their mind and simply dump the garbage. So when we are not applying our mind in this kind of activity, definitely that results into all these kind of things. So for development, if you think if you want to come out with a developed society, either in your street, in your ward, or in your place, if you think you want to make a development society, please give importance for SHE. SHE stands for safety, health and environment. And if you want to incorporate safety, then you have to be mindful. You have to apply mind whatever activity you are doing. Without mindfulness, SHE cannot be enhanced. Without SHE, there is no development. Over to you, please.
It's a wonderful speech, V.D.M. Sundaram sir, be mindful of it. Excellent term. This is one of the best takeaway for me in this meeting. I hope it's the best takeaway for everyone else also. Because these are the little things that we can incorporate in our life for our safety and for our friends or for the other people's safety also. Do not engage while driving or put the garbage in the current position.